new incorporated features in CoWIN.
OTP authentication for on-spot registrations. At the time of on-spot registration for dose 1 and dose 2, beneficiary has to share one-time password for registration through vaccinator module. So as a routine process, when vaccinator will go ahead and add the beneficiary for the session, vaccinator has to enter identification details like photo ID card, photo ID number, beneficiary type, name, gender, year of birth, and mobile number. Upon clicking on continue, system will ask for one-time password, which will be provided by the beneficiaries. Upon entering one-time password, vaccinator has to verify the OTP and then click on register. The beneficiary can then successfully add it to the session. In case of network constraint, vaccinator will have an option to proceed without OTP. This feature is not applicable for persons without identity sessions. So once the vaccinator will register the beneficiary for the session and click on continue, after 15 seconds, the option to proceed without one-time password will pop up. Upon clicking that, the vaccinator has to re-enter the mobile number to ensure that the mobile number is correct. And then the beneficiary can be registered for the session. ID card validation on on-spot registration. Implemented ID card validation on on-spot registration, user will be prompted for duplicate ID card like Aadhaar number while beneficiary is getting registered on-spot. So when the vaccinator will add the beneficiary or register the beneficiary in the session, let us take an example here. We enter Aadhaar card number 5505570092 for Mr. Kumar Gaurav. We enter gender, year of birth, type of beneficiary and mobile number and register the beneficiary. Now we add another beneficiary, and by mistake we try and enter the same Aadhaar number, which is 5505560557 0092. We enter relevant details and mobile number. Now if we try and register another beneficiary with the same Aadhaar number, the system will going to prompt, as you can see on the screen, that Mr. Kumar Gaurav with so-and-so Aadhaar card and mobile number is already registered. So multiple registration with same Aadhaar number or any other photo ID cannot be done. 18 plus age group session. DIO or site manager can now create session for 18 plus age group. 18 plus age group will consider for all beneficiaries over 18 years. Users will not be able to create sessions for 18 to 44 or 45 plus for the same day if a session for 18 plus is created for any vaccine and vice versa. So district immunization can log in, navigate to vaccination center and then click on manage session. The DIO can select date, start time, end time, and in the age section you can see 18 plus, 18 to 44 and 45 plus option. So upon selection of vaccine and declaring the
capacity for online slot dose 1, dose 2, on-spot slot dose 1 and dose 2. District Immunization Officer or CVC Manager can create a session. On the same day, when we have created a session for 18+, if we try and create another session for 18 to 44 or 45+, the system will not allow us to do that. For example, here we are creating a session for 18 to 44. It will give an error that already there is a session with same age range is there. And similarly, if we create a session for 45+, system will prompt that already a session is created which is catering to this particular age group. In the self-registration module, if we take an example, here one person is registered with the age group of 45+, year of birth 1975, and if we see, there are two sessions, one is 18+, and another is 18 to 44 and 45 and above. So you can see this person is not able to book session in 18 to 44 category. However, for 18+, the person can book the appointment. Similarly, if there is a beneficiary with the age group of 18 to 44, like here with year of birth 2000, the beneficiary can search for the session of either 18 to 44 or 18+. And book an appointment. So in the same session, 45+ age group and 18 to 44 age group can book an appointment if it is 18+ session.